Welcome to my new video. In this video I will show you how to read information from an invoice. This is the invoice file that we want to read out. We want to read out the following information: vendor address, city, telephone number, invoice number, bank name, bank account, IBAN code, and the vendor name. The following variables are required for the code. Please create these variables first. All are from type string. Only variable array text is from type list of string. Furthermore, the PDF activities are necessary. If you don't have them, import them. See this video on my channel to learn how to import these. Use the activity, read PDF text. Add the path of the PDF file. Set the output variable. Now we have the entire content of the PDF file in one variable, extracted text. We convert the text to an array, so that we can work better and can easily read out the values. Now let's start reading the information from the invoice. First we start with the vendor address. It's the first element in the array. We continue with the city. It is the second element in the array, because it is on the second line of the PDF file. The name of the city is not alone in the line, but there is more information in the same line, so we split the text using the comma, and only take what comes before the comma. Let's continue with the invoice number. I will explain this in detail because it's a bit complicated. At the beginning we save the text in an array. The different lines are stored in the array. The invoice number is on the third line. We take the third line first. We get the following output. You can see that this is splitted with a comma. We split based on this comma and take what comes after the comma. We get the following output. This string contains spaces, so we split and delete the space from the string. We get the following output. Now we split based on the hashtag and take what comes after the hashtag. So we get the invoice number. Let's continue with the vendor name. We set the number for the index as the count of the entire array minus 9. As we can see here in the PDF file, the name is on the 9th line from the bottom, so we enter count minus 9. We build a loop for the array to read out further information. The type argument is string. We check whether the item contains the word bank name. If so, we split the string using the colon and take what comes after the colon. We check whether the item contains the word IBAN code. If so, we split the string using the colon and take what comes after the colon. We check whether the item contains the word bank account. If so, we split the string using the colon and take what comes after the colon. We build a new loop for the array to read out the phone number. The type argument is string. We check whether the item contains the word phone. If so, we split the string using the colon and take what comes after the colon. It is the same here as with the invoice number. The only difference is that we read out the first string and not the second as with the invoice number. We build a break in this loop, so that the loop is stopped when we get the first phone number, because the phone number appears twice in the invoice, and we need the first phone number. After we have read out all the information, we will write this information in a text file. We do this with the write text file activity. Enter the path of the text file. Then enter what is to be written in this file. Now we can run the code. Oops! I wrote the PDF file name wrong. It should be NPO, not NOP. Now we can run the code again. As we see, there is a new text file created. You can see the values which we read out from the invoice. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like and comment. See you in the next videos.